Are you kidding me? Oh, come on. What an idiot. Oh, right. Hey, Siri. Back me up. Come on. Perfect. Hey, Siri, stop. Hey, wait. Apple users know that Siri hasn't really been very good and, well, forever. But a new Apple app called Shortcuts, released alongside iOS 12 a few days ago, allows you to do some really cool stuff, like program and also download automated actions, which can be triggered by Siri, basically making your iPhone a pre-programmed, pre-automated supercomputer. It's really cool. The problem is the app's a little bit intimidating and a lot of people don't know how to get started. So I'm here to show you exactly how it works. Okay, so to get awesome shortcuts on your iOS device, you are, perhaps obviously, going to need the application Shortcuts. Now, this was previously called Workflow, but Apple bought the app and the company and have released it with more power than ever before. To download the latest version, you are going to need iOS 12 or later, because that's required for the Siri Shortcuts. If you haven't updated, if your device runs iOS 11, it will run iOS 12, and it does quite a good job, so you should update anyway. But once you've done that, you can open the application. Now, I have a few shortcuts here that have been pre-programmed, but your page is going to be blank. You won't have anything. Just to give you some background on how you can trigger some shortcuts, you can either do it from the app page itself, you can also do it from your Notification Center widget, and then you can lastly do it through Siri. That's the method that I've found the most interesting and fun. Now, you might be wondering, well, how do I find shortcuts? Because I have 7 here and you have 0. Well, there are a few ways. The easiest is to use the built-in gallery that Apple has curated. Now, because Apple has curated it, it's a little bit more limited than you might expect, but there are actually some pretty cool actions in here. For example, if we go into the photography section, my favorite one is convert burst photo to GIF. So you click it and then you can click get shortcut, and it automatically installs into your library. Now, a burst photo is if you open up your camera and hold down the shutter button, it takes, you know, a bunch of photos in sequence. Those aren't very useful because you click the photo and you're usually able to select one of 25 photos as the main photo. However, if you use this convert burst to GIF shortcut, you can click it. It wants you to choose the burst image, so that's the one we just took, and then it will convert it to a GIF. Pretty cool. You can click done, and then it will ask you whether you want to share it, or save it to your photo roll, or cancel. So that's what we're going to do. So the first way to find shortcuts is through Apple's own gallery. The second way, which is going to become increasingly more common, is third-party applications. Third-party app devs can create their own Siri shortcuts that are pre-curated that you can enable in the settings application. So if you go into settings, click a third-party app, and then you click the Siri and search button, you'll find that there is now a shortcuts section. That will only pop up if the third-party developer has supported shortcuts. So Overcast, which is my podcast app of choice, supports Siri shortcuts. And one of my favorite podcasts is Connected. So there is a command called play Connected that I can add, and then I have to create a Siri command. Now, I can do the recommended one, Overcast Connected, but I can make it literally anything I want. So I'm going to call it play Connected Podcast. And now that's my hotkey. So anytime I say that from anywhere in iOS, play Connected Podcast. It will resume the episode that I'm currently listening to without me having to do anything, without me having to enter the app, without me having to use the Apple Podcast app. It's really cool. And I am betting that there are going to be a ton of powerful features that make it into third-party applications. There's one other way to find really great shortcuts, and that is using the subreddit Shortcuts. When people have made shortcuts, you can actually share them with others, and so Reddit is a great place to find a bunch of ones that people have created. A lot of them are really useful and super powerful, and a lot of them are very stupid and absurd, like this one, which is called the Pineapple Incident. I can click download, and the URL opens inside of the app, and I can actually see what this app does by scrolling through this text. Now, this one's actually pretty involved, but what it does is it picks a random content, a random contact, and sends the pineapple emoji in iMessage 100 times. Really bad shortcut. You'll never want to use that one. But if you wanted to, you could. So those are three ways to find pre-made shortcuts: in the gallery, in the settings app, and on Reddit or online sharing with your friends. But you can also make your own shortcuts. Before we get to that, I do want to show you two handy tricks. To rearrange your shortcuts that you have, you just hold it down until they wiggle, just like on the app home screen, and you can move them around. And then to delete them or duplicate them, you just select the shortcuts you want so they have a blue check mark next to them, and then you can duplicate or delete. So that's one thing to note. The other thing worth noting is how you actually trigger them with Siri. So this is my calculate tip function, which I use all the time. And historically, I've gone into here, scrolled over, and clicked calculate tip. It asked me the bill when I'm at a restaurant, I type, I don't know, $58.72. It asked me how much I want to tip, 20%. And then it gives me my tip amount and my total amount. Pretty cool. But let's say I want to trigger that using Siri. Well, I can. If I go into the calculate tip settings, I can click this little guy right here, and then click add to Siri. Then I create a shortcut. What's my tip? And then now, anywhere in iOS, I can trigger Siri. What's my tip? And my shortcut will run. It asks me for the bill. It tells me asks me what I want to tip, so $14. And then let's do 20%. And then there you go. My tip is $2.80, and my total is $16.80. So pretty good. That's how you do it. But again, I mentioned you can make your own shortcut. I just bought a Tesla Model 3 and I am very excited about it. And I'll talk about it later in the future. A lot of people want a full review. I'll do that once I've had the car for a few months. But one of the things that I've really enjoyed is that Tesla has an open API. So there is an application called Remote S, which allows you to do quite a few more things than the regular Tesla app does. I can change the exact temperature, I can open the trunk and the frunk, I can honk the horn. Most of those the regular Tesla app can do, but I can do a few other things like track the app or track the car's location in real time, modify charge settings, etc. Anyway, that's probably more than you care to know. Remote S has a few pre-made functions, like I mentioned with Overcast. So if I go here and then I scroll down to Remote S, I can click a Siri and search, shortcuts, and I can create an activate frunk. So that will open the front trunk on my car. If I tap add, I can say, that's actually a good command, I'll use that. Open the frunk. And when I say open the frunk, using Siri, open the frunk.
Ready to do it with Remote S?
In theory, it opens your trunk. Now, the problem with this is I don't like it because it requires an extra step. It asks me, do I want to open it? And if it asks me that, I have to have the phone in my hand to tap yes or no, or to give it a verbal confirmation. And I don't really want to do that. So I can actually modify this shortcut. Let's delete it first. And then I can create my own inside of shortcuts. So I'm going to go into shortcuts, create a shortcut. And now you can actually see that there are a bunch of options here that you can create your own shortcut. So you can open an app, you can do a calendar event, you can do scripting, which we'll talk about in a minute. Or I can scroll down to a pre-made shortcut, Remote S, tap it. Tap the activate trunk command, and then I can actually just disable show when run. This means that everything will happen in the background. I don't need to provide confirmation. And the minute I say open trunk, well, it'll open. I'm going to turn that off, and then I am going to click the icon to add to Siri, and now I need to give it a Siri command. So open the frunk. All right. And then I can change the shortcut if I want. So let's call this open frunk. And then I can give it an icon if I want. So let's make it a car. And then red. Okay. So now, anywhere in iOS, I'm done. And I can go open the frunk. The shortcut will run. And it opens without me having to do anything. Let me demonstrate. Hey Siri, open frunk. But I can already see some of you saying, that doesn't seem very secure. And you're right. So the great thing about this is that I can make this workflow a little bit more complex. And I wanted to do it by adding a verbal password. So let's start over. I'll show you basically how powerful this can get if you're willing to play around and read the descriptions on some of these items. So let's go into scripting. Scripting is cool because it allows you to create a bunch of conditional logic items. So if I'm going to give it a password, let's say when I say open the frunk, it'll say, okay, fine, what's your password? So what I need to do is find an area or an item where I can dictate text to the device. It's not in here. It's actually probably going to be in text. And then I can click, there you go, dictate text. So now what happens when I run the workflow is it wants me to say something out loud. And then when I'm done, it will pass whatever I say onto the next step. Now we haven't programmed a next step yet, so nothing happens. But let's keep that, that's fine. And then it actually wants me, that's the dictate text that I'm looking for, so let's re-add it. Dictate text, perfect. And then once I pause, it stops listening and it passes it on to the next step. So now we need the next step, and let's use a variable. These are pretty powerful. So if I use an if variable, this is where we get into conditional logic. So it gives me a few options. If something happens, then do this. Otherwise, do that, and then end the command. So I'm going to dictate text, say my password, that's what I want it to say, but it doesn't know what it's looking for. So if my input equals, because it's a password, if it's not perfectly correct, then it shouldn't unlock the car. And then we need to enter the value. That's the password that it's looking for. I don't know, let's do coconut. That will be my password. Okay, so if I dictate text and that text equals coconut, then do what we want it to do, which is open the trunk. So now we're going to go in here, find my remote S again, and then click activate trunk. Oh, no, we want the frunk. Activate the frunk, okay? And then we're going to cancel show and run, because again, we don't need that to pop up. And we need to drag that inside of our if variable. So if I say the right password, then open the trunk. And that's really all I need to do. But what if they enter the wrong password? So otherwise, meaning they don't say a value that equals coconut, they say something else, the wrong password, then we need to punish them somehow. Now, I could just end it and the script doesn't complete properly, but that's no fun. So let's throw some variables in here that will let the person know that they've done the wrong thing. Maybe someone steals my phone and they try to break into my car using my Siri shortcut. Well, what can I do to let them know they've screwed up? Let's go into scripting again. And this does a lot of low-level device features. You can, for example, vibrate the device. So let's vibrate like a buzzer. Otherwise, if they get it wrong, so we're gonna drag this into otherwise. So when they say the wrong password, the device is going to vibrate, kind of like a zzz, wrong answer. And then, what else could we do? I've got it. We can Rickroll them. So if I enter this area, I can find that there is a music shortcut. I click music, and then let's see. Okay, well, we need to find the music because the music app doesn't know to Rickroll unless we tell it to find the song and then play it. So we need to click find music. We're going to drag that again, underneath this tree of command. So otherwise, vibrate the device, and then find music. So we need to add a filter. And the song, so we need to find title, is Never Gonna Give You Up. And we need to do the exact whole title, otherwise it's not gonna work. Okay, so we've done Never Gonna Give You Up. And then after that, do you know what's even better? Let's raise the volume to 100% so it's really loud and really annoying. So let's go into scripting. We will go down to set volume and we can make the volume of the system 100%. That is going to be really irritating. So what happens is if they get the wrong password, the device vibrates, the volume on the device gets set to 100%. It looks for the song Never Gonna Give You Up, and now we only need one more thing, and that's to tell the device to play the song. So we need to go into music and then click play music. And then it will actually play the song that we've listed. So there's our workflow, it's done. That's all we have to do. And so let's work through it again. It's going to ask us when we say, hey Siri, I probably shouldn't say that. I'm gonna say, hey Dingleberry, open the frunk. And when I say open the frunk, it's gonna say, okay. It's gonna ask me to dictate some text. and I need to say the password. If I say coconut, then the trunk opens. If I don't say coconut, then this tree of items happens, which is the device vibrates, the volume gets set to 100%, iTunes looks up, never gonna give you up, and then it plays it at full blast. And that's my command. I press done, and it's ready to go. So let's try it out. Hey Siri, open frunk. Coconut. Hey Siri, open frunk. Password? Well, folks, that's all for me. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. If you didn't, well, that other button seems to work okay too. Get subscribed for more awesome videos like these, but most importantly, and as always, stay snazzy.